Yo, what's up, everybody? This is Institution of None and All. I am your host, King Bullshit, the Dome of the Rock. So, since yesterday, I put myself out into the world, said, hey, look, I'm in the ring, man. My hat is in the contest. Let me be your leader, and I will lead you to the promised land, no matter where you live in the whole world. I don't need nothing from you. Just come to my YouTube, come to my page, listen to what I say, take it to heart, think about it, and watch what happens. And people say, that sounds good and everything, man, but do you have any more plans? Do you have anything like better than that? And I'm like, yeah, of course. Are you kidding? Like, you think I'm a one-trick pony? Come on. I'm not even a pony. All right. So, say I had 12 people. This is theoretically, you know, hypothetically, whatever those two things mean. I don't think they're the same, and I don't think it matters. But check it out. In my wildest imagination, say I had 12 people, and I think that's possible because there's more than 12 people following the channel right now. Say I had 12 people, and they were real people, and they were all in front of me, and they were all like, hey, dude, whatever you want us to do, we'll do. All right, what would I do? Okay, well, this is what I would do. I have three things, three-point platform, basically, for changing the world, get 12 people, okay? First thing you need to do is you need to have education. Okay? And that's a two-way street. I mean, coming and going. So we're educating ourselves on each other, on our relationships, on how to better ourselves. I'm doing this along with everyone else because I need it as much as anyone, if not more, right? I'm the one who fucks all this stuff up in the first place. Everybody blame me for everything. Well, if you believe, never mind. Anyway, so there we go. We're going to educate people both ways. What do we mean by education? Well, check it out. Tai Chi, as a realization, is what everyone is really grasping for. All of the mysticism, doing DMT, or whatever you want to talk about, like I read about these things, Terrence McKenna talks about it, Timothy Leary talked about it, all the hippies are talking about it, the Psy Trance Nation's talking about it, the shamans are talking about it, the trance dance, existence, you know, DJs, musicians, artists, everyone in the world, the whole Zen thing. Everybody's trying to reach this inner thing, this Kabbalistic, you know, fine line in the center of all of us that cuts right through everything and lines everything up and just makes the universe perfect for everyone, right? Makes perfect for you, makes perfect for others. And when it happens for you and you get that ding inside of you, man, nothing can bring you down, and the whole universe lines up to make what you need to have happen happen. When the universe doesn't line up for you, you realize, wow, that wasn't even like the universe doing something bad for me. That was the universe actually doing something good for me, getting blessing in disguise. You're happy about everything. You know, that's when Tai Chi lines up, okay? It's called, like, Christians know this thing as having the spirit upon you. You know, it's the ability to look out into the universe and make absolute sense of it. Heads, tails, everything. It all lines up. It makes sense. It's perfect. Okay? That's what people want. Okay? And it's within reach right now. It's really within reach right now. There are a lot of people who already have it. They're furiously trying to pump it out, even though, you know, the first thing it says in the Lao Tzu is that you can't talk about it in words, but people, I believe you can, and people, you know, I believe that's meant to make you think something. It's almost like it's a metaphorical explanation for the nature of the Tao. But the reality is that we're humans and we communicate, and that's what our whole programming and social interactions and everything about our cultural and, in, you know, our own preferences, our personal, the DNA of our personality, the DNA, if you will, of your cultural mainframe, your little cults, your little, you know, those are bites for culture. That's a joke. Anyways, so we educate people on this middle ground that has been found. It's theories of everything. They're all based on Tai Chi, and they make everything come together so that your worldview clicks and that you understand things. You don't even have to be the same as everybody else. You're already the same as everybody else. Therefore, you're free to be different. It's great. We get people to understand that. And you can do that through anthropology as a scientific vehicle. I think anthropology leans toward that. I think it bends toward that. I think, you know, if you study anthropology, first of all, is not a four-discipline field. Every single field of study that human beings do, it's technically anthropology and should be considered as such. That's one of the first arguments I'm making about education. Anthropology is the holistic science of taking all of the sciences and rolling them around in a big hopper and seeing what the relationships between them are and how they inform each other and how it all works together for both individuals and society. Anthropology is never taking a narrower view. It's always taking a more expansive view. That's the type of education that Tai Chi puts upon you. This is basically what Confucius is trying to tell people. You understand? This is basically what the way of the Native American is ultimately trying to get you to understand about the universe around you. That everything has a divine order, and that divine order is obvious and blatant. And if you can't see it, it's because you're refusing to. So that's the first thing. We educate ourselves on these things, come together, we understand that. Now, what's the next step? Church hop. When you get people who understand Tai Chi, and they have internalized it, they have awoken their inner Atman, they've set their soul on fire, they are ready for Satyagraha, they are ready to go out and change the world. The problem is that these people are always doing the wrong thing. They are running out to the government, and they're getting their heads cracked open by cops. And this is terrible. It's not working. It's not ever going to work. You're just going to keep standing up against these guys, and they're just going to keep beating you down. And you think that pretty soon they're all going to start puking on their boots and dropping their weapons and putting flowers in their hair, and it's not going to happen. Because there are always more angry, frustrated, young, savage, sadistic men who love to torture and kill and hurt and maim and beat things up. And the government is always going to hire those guys to do their fucking dirty work. Now, so this is the thing that I'm trying to say, and this is where the whole divine government thing comes in. This is what the world has been waiting for someone to come and say this for all the time, because this is the thing, is if the world is filled with lies and all of its social facts and it's all run by the greediest men in the world, then you can tell that whatever is the biggest, you know, sham lama ding dong thing, the biggest ba da 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 da, where are they throwing all their money and their interest at trying to get you to believe the bullshit? And if you don't see that it's support of the military industrial complex, but yet you can't watch the news and see that everywhere shit is just terrible, you got the military industrial complex, they're making it worse. Well, if you don't understand that, you're obviously brainwashed. You're freaking dead inside, and you are either part of it, you're too scared to do anything about it, or you're too stupid to recognize it's there. And I'm sorry to have to say that to so many people. That's like everyone on the planet right now, almost. But this is the thing. Gandhi, Martin Luther King, you know, Albert Einstein is on record saying if the world ever wants to, you know, become the utopia that scientists and secularists think that it's going to become, we're going to have to get rid of war. And if the scientists and the secularists would ever acknowledge that they blame religion for war all the time, yet religion teaches people not to make war, and war is made by warriors. And then the scientists make the weapons and they sell them to the warriors, and there's a little bit of a twisted relationship there. Now, so what do we do about this? Well, it's obvious. You got to come up with other institutions to give you what you need and solve your problems. Now, some people are like, hey, I'm a rugged individualist. I can walk for hundreds of miles by myself. I don't need anything. I killed deer with my bare hands. I know how to make a bow and arrow. I know how to light shit on fire just by thinking about it with my mind. I don't need to eat. I don't need to sleep. I don't need to drink water. I'm a freaking camel. Great. You're awesome, all right? But here's the thing. Most people need organization. Most people need in-groups. Most people need family. And when you don't have that, life goes to shit. When you don't have that, you're living in the ravine in a tent, hoping that the cops don't come in on dirt bikes every night. You know, you're fed, maybe, but you're going to die on the trail. You know, alone, cold, frozen, stiff. It'd be days before somebody finds you, and ain't nobody going to remember you. Okay? That's not as good as having a life where, you know, people touch you, they love you, they rub your back, you know what I'm saying? They help groom your hair or whatever. You know what I'm saying? That's not as good as that. It's not as good as being able to eat with people, being able to cook with them, being able to help share in the chores and the, you know, job of like cleaning up and like making sure everybody has enough. It's not as good as having people to play sports with and, you know,
you can go play volleyball at the park, and, you know, everybody can go out dancing on Saturday night and crack a few beers and have a fucking orgy. That's better than the rugged individual dying on the trail because they got nowhere to go, no one to take care of them. You know what I'm saying? Because they lost all their family, because they ran out of friends, they ran out of options, because people create their bubbles and they're not completely impermeable, but they're for the most part impermeable, and so forth. You know, these people have a very difficult time getting into an in-group, even if it is open and available to them. So what do I plan? How do you reverse this? How do you fix this issue? Because it has benefits and problems, and those have been noted, and we've got years of individualist versus communistic communal living. We've got, you know, whatever. You want to be spiritual but not religious, right? Good for you. You're on your own. For the rest of us, hey, you know what? I've done spiritual but not religious. It doesn't do anything for you eventually, okay? Eventually, what you need is a spiritual church, which is really, for me, why I left, you know, the church that I was part of as my parents brought me into it in the first place. It wasn't because I didn't believe in the religion. It was because they weren't following it. But anyways, that's, you know, so different people are going to leave for different reasons. So some people that aren't even interested. If you're not, why are you still watching this? And so if you are, what I'm suggesting is that rather than try to establish your own group where you do your own thing, what you do instead is as a group, right? You get, remember, I have 12 people. If you're following me and you're still here, you're one of the 12. Okay, so I have 12 people and we're going church hopping. What we're going to do is we're going to go, not to our church, we're going to go to everyone else's place of worship, everything. And I'm not talking about like limiting just to the other Christians or limiting just to whoever, the other Dallas in my case. But there aren't any Dallas up here either. There's like a couple like lone teachers who like walk around and teach Taoism in the park, and like there's no Dallas community where I live, which is a shame, because Christians vacating Christianity love to run, especially to Buddhism, and, you know, a close second are impersonal, westernized, kind of like economic negotiations of Hinduism, things like yoga, where you stretch and breathe, and that's not what yoga means. Anyways, so what I'm saying is actually doing what no one else does, and it's like anthropology, it's field work, it's like tourism, it's actually fascinating, it's hard to do, there's one thing that many people will understand is that if you've been to universities right now, they use a tactic for people who do social science studies, and that tactic is that you have to go to church with some group you've never been with before, and you have to observe them for the whole thing, and then you have to come back and write a report on what you saw, and it has to be relatively objective, and you know, not just objective, but that it has to isolate salient components of structural functionism that matter and that can be analyzed for data that can then be extrapolated and used for meaningful projections about the human condition and how to transcend it. So that's what we do, is we go around to everyone and then we get the full complement of that, and what you get is an appreciation for religion that you will never get from doing anything else. There is no process of doing things that will bring you to the awareness about humans and societal relationships that doing this church hopping project will do. You can do it alone. If you are out there and you're listening to this and you're all alone and you're not with me, I say go and do this. Now, what I mean to do is to take the church hopping thing tighter, closer, cleaner, more together, and say, like, for example, I have 12 people right here in Sebastopol, and I can go and church hop in this town. Well, what do you think will happen if I go church hop Sebastopol with 12 people for 6 months straight? Well, first of all, the churches are all going to fold they're not going to be able to do anything else. It will be too apparent and too direct and too clear what is happening. And their leadership, you know, structure, the vertical component of their, you know, of their experience, of their paradigm, is going to pretty much heal. And I mean that Kabbalistically. I mean H-E-A-L, and I mean H-E-E-L. What I would have them do is another talk for another time, but I'm just making that clear to all of you. If I could get 12 people to go with me consistently to visit these churches, we're not going to bother them. We're not going to disrupt them. We're not going to be, you know, foul mouth, you know, smoking, drinking, belching, whoring, wenching, renegades, waving our pirate flags, being like, "Arr, we've come for your women and your children." Arr! No, we're not. Like, most of them don't have, you know, kids. Anyways, the vast majority of people who go to church on a Sunday or at any other time in this area are older people who are, you know, don't have young kids. But that's just an anthropological observation that I've made. So anyways, church hop. And so what happens is they get wind of your project. They start doing it. They start opening up. Pretty soon you get things like what we already have in Sebastopol, which is an interfaith association between them. And I'll tell you right now, if you're sleeping out on the trail and you're about to die, guess who is the group of people who lets you shower and feeds you a meal every other Saturday or whatever and make sure you've got enough sleeping bags and socks and sack lunches? Well, it's the Interfaith Association. So it's just food for thought, people, something to think about. You want to heal your world? You want to heal your politicians? Heal the world, H-E-A-L, heal the world, and heal, H-E-E-L, your politicians? Well, guess what? It's working for Christianity. How do you think you keep this bloated, disgusting beast of the GOP alive without a religious component functioning behind it? Can you imagine what would happen if there was a liberal, new age, open-minded, interfaith, religious component to drive the true left majority of the United States into the new world? Wow. Whole different future than the one we're expecting, huh? All right, so anyways, so like, that's what I'm saying. If you're one of those 12 people, rep this shit, because it's important. All right, now, what do I need? What do I need? What do I need from those 12 people? I just said it. I need you to rep this shit. It's important. Give me chatter. Let people know. Talk about it. Spread it. Do it. Yes. I want you to go, if you're in another country, if you're in another state, if you're watching this and you know me, I'm not kidding. I want you to go to church everywhere you can, as much as you can, until your Tai Chi experience solidifies and seals and you can judge it by your synchronicity stream, which should be tight and on point. It should be constantly, the whole world should be speaking to you of your existence, which is what I have. What you want. So, you know, in addition to going and doing the field work, which is the field work component, which is going and doing this, get chatter. You don't have to go with me. I can get a group of 12 to work in Sebastopol. Shit in Sebastopol is going to change. Let me tell you something. Pretty soon, everybody going to have a house. Everybody going to be taken care of. Everybody going to be happy. There's going to be food, and you all going to know what's in it. Okay? The whole thing, the motorcycles and trucks racing up and down your streets with freaking terrorists in them is going to stop. Because those guys aren't going to want to live here anymore. Because people are going to be happy. And they don't feed off of happiness. They feed off of suffering. You understand? We eliminate the suffering in this city, and it's going to spread across this whole world. But that's just if I get people to do this with me. Okay? But in the meantime, if you can't do this with me, you out in your own place. You're in Arizona. You're in England. You're in New Jersey. You're all over the place. I got people coming at me from all over the place. Man, what up Pakistan? What up Malaysia? What up, Canada, India? You know what I'm saying? What up Greece, what up Europe, all of Europe. I got people everywhere in Europe. What up South Africa, what up Australia. I got tons of people from Australia watching these. I don't know if they're watching this video, but I know they're following the page. I don't know if that means they're actually following it, but hey, I can say how many people like this, and a lot of them from Australia. So that's what I'm saying. If you're anywhere in the world, and you go and you do this, what you're going to do is you're going to start to understand people no matter who they are, first of all, because dropping yourself into these anthropological field experience immersion programs where, boom, all of a sudden you're with these people in their most intimate foreign moment, and it's sacred and it's holy, and if you make any fun of it or do anything wrong, you're going to feel like shit, and God probably going to give you some instant karma, going to get you. So you have to sit there and nod and shake hands and smile and make it through to the end. And once you've done that enough times, man, there are very few people in this world that you can find yourself disgusted with. Really, it's pretty much comes down to people who are killing other people and destroying their lives. And, man, you know what I found? They put labels on those guys. They give them, like, bells and whistles and lights and shit to let you know, woo, 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 they're coming. But anyways, so feedback. If you say, hey, man, like, you're crazy or you're stupid or you swear too much or I don't dig the militant pacifism or you smoke too much or you drink too much or you do too many drugs, which I don't do any drugs. I smoke and I drink, and I don't think that I smoke or drink too much. I think that I smoke and drink too little. To be honest with you, I would like to smoke and drink more, but shit happens, life goes on, and I don't have time for that, or money, or, you know, the stamina, or the constitution. Anyways, this is another story. Don't shoot the messenger, you know what I'm saying? This is more important. If you think to yourself, man, we can't use this guy because his tongue is all swolled up, and he doesn't even have his hair anymore, and he's crazy, and he's not well-spoken, and he's obviously, you know, whatever, like, I don't know. I don't know what, like, everything that could be bad about me, all right? Take everything that's bad about me, roll it up into a big, giant cookie, and then put it out there and say, hey, look, man, do you want to eat this cookie, or do you want to listen to what I said? You understand what I'm saying? So anyways, that's what I need. I need feedback for what I say. It's more important than what you don't like, but if you don't like something, give me that feedback too, because I'm open to everything. All right, so what's the goal? Right now, immediately, my goal, you know, not globally, but locally. I think globally, I act locally. My goal here locally is to secure a building. Every church building in this town is on its way out of business. That's for sure. There's a couple of them that are easily for sale. And, man, if I had one of those places, let me tell you something. Not only would my experience change completely, I would become what I need to be, which is a minister, a person who 24/7, 365, my only concern is making sure that other people have what they need and get what they want and are taken care of and that their problems are solved. Mediator, a friend, a cook, everything, a doctor, whatever. Whatever you need, I am going to tend to your needs if I have a building. Okay, there. No one's gonna sleep outside. No one is gonna go hungry, and there's never gonna not be something to do. There's never gonna not be a safe place that you can go, and the door is gonna be open, and you can get in there, and you're gonna be safe. Okay, that's never gonna happen. And that's what I'm talking about. Is if those things were on every corner like 7-Elevens, this world wouldn't have no problems. So, if I can start to secure buildings, and you know, at a building, there are no rules about how you produce food. There are no rules about what you do with the food afterward. You are free, especially under the banner of religion, because another reason that I'm working with religion is, folks, believe it or not, this is the oldest way of social organization. It's way better than politics, and it's way better than secular idealism. It speaks directly to people, and it acts in a holistic manner that ties your entire personal experience to the social experience of the entire universe around you.
That's why it's effective. That's why it matters. The symbolism inside it is deep. It speaks to your core fibers. It gets you at the center of what your consciousness is and what it means to be a human being. So that's all the theoretical and the spiritual side of it. But if that thing doesn't manifest in a place for you to go and a way for you and the people around you to build community, bounce off of each other, share with each other, eat with each other, drink with each other, dance with each other, sing with each other, play with each other, marry each other, love each other, raise your kids together, teach them how to do math, teach them how to argue out their problems, teach them how to defend themselves through, you know, Tai Chi, martial, it's a martial art too? Are you kidding, dude? What doesn't Tai Chi do? It does open cans. I'm sorry. There's nothing Tai Chi doesn't do. Anyways, so we get stuff, we get tools, we get property, we get land, and we take care of each other on it. Doesn't that sound awesome? Like, I mean, especially to my specific group of friends, do you realize that if my friends from when I was in high school, if we had all bonded together and put our money into the same pool collectively from the time that we were back then, like when we did, when we were kids on the block, that's how we got out. You know what I'm saying? That's how we broke out. I got five on it. And you. We got a dub sack. Now we got something to do. You know what I'm saying? That's, folks, we could all have a boat, a van, a truck, a building, a garden, our own apartment complex. Like, if me and my friends right here in Sebastopol right now, the ones, all we do is get together and play volleyball, yo, for real, I know that that's not the only thing we do to get together and play volleyball, but like, if we get together and set our sights on something bigger and realer than volleyball, we're going to make our problems go away and create a new social fabric, safety net system of getting everything we want and we need, that we don't have to suck up and be part of original sin for. You know what I'm saying? The worst thing is that we have to join a group and become part of a social unit. The terror of being with other people. For some of us, that's the way it is. But that's what I'm saying. That's like, at worst, you have to prostitute yourself to your friends and be like, all right, I'm willing to do whatever you need me to do in exchange for some cookies. And that's quid pro quo. That's how life in the monkey game works. So why, you ask? Why are you telling us this if this is nothing new? And actually, I'm asking you, why do I have to tell you this? This is nothing new. The reality is, especially for secular humanists who believe in evolution and like are all Darwinist about how stupid the religious people are, let me tell you something. There's a reason that when you look at the red and the blue counties, the red counties are much, the amount of land that they have is much more. And guess what? They've got the better land. They've got the land with all the cows and the chickens and the farms. They've got all the land that everybody wants. I live in one of the only places in the world where it's farmland and it's blue. Pretty much in every state, the blue won because it was where the cities are, you know? And the red is all of the people who, guess what? How do they organize? What's their social unit? I'll give you one guess. It's not atheism. So I'm trying to tell you, folks, the reason that it works for them is that it works. It's a good adaptive strategy. It's one that is successful. Religion is in your Darwinistic interests. Now, real religion, which is what None and All is, it is a religion that teaches people militant pacifism, don't kill each other, and hey, everybody's cool, be open. Like, just because somebody comes from a different group than you do and they do a different dance and they eat a different food and they have a different way of saying things, ultimately they are just the same as you. And that if everyone is taught that, the world might not be so bad after all. And I can guarantee you that neither of the two men that you pretended to vote for last night are going to give you a solution as concise and eloquent and elegant and sophisticated and possible as that one. And guess what, folks? This doesn't take bullets. This revolution will not need a single battle won. It won't. It's a revolution of the mind, it's a revolution of the heart, it's a revolution of the spirit, and it's a revolution of the individual transforming into a revolution of socio-cultural paradigms and patterns of the past, which is the reality. If those of you who thought that you were going to be jumping off and, you know, everyone was just going to suddenly elevate and turn into light beings, we're not there yet, right? You have to go through this to get to that. And it's line upon line, piece upon piece. We're going to go one step at a time, okay? And it's honestly, it's pretty bad that you need someone to come down here and explain all this to you and put themselves on the line and drive that stake so far into themselves that they become the nexus connected black hole metaphorical center of the universe in their own internal body and their own ego, so that the whole world will go, wow, that is a message that you can't deny. That's a message that you can't really, that's everything that's ever been. They have that story on Jupiter, man. Yes, they do. So anyways, it's nothing new. I'm Blue. And sucks to be you. If it sucks to be you, excuse me. If it sucks to be you, come back tomorrow and don't watch the video until the end.